This is Diaspora Network Television. My name is Jermaine Nkrumah. We're here with Ambassador Erica Bennett and the world famous Tanya Sam, right? Very good with your mask today. She must be special because you don't have a, you have a mask on. She doesn't take her mask off for nobody.
I appreciate it.
So what does this visit mean to you?
Well, we're just excited to have her here. She is a true diaspora. When we talk about somebody who has connections in different countries, this is the one. You know, I didn't know about her until I was reading all the fantastic things that she's doing, and we're very proud of her. And we're going to make her part of the Diaspora Africa Forum family. So we're very excited to have her, and we want to welcome you to the Diaspora Africa Forum. And thank you, Jermaine, for all the wonderful things that you continue to do. The Diaspora Network Television is exactly what we need to tell our stories in a real way and from our perspective.
Thank you. We got out of the car about it simultaneously, and when you got out of the car, the first words out of your mouth, oh my God, this is gorgeous. What struck you the most about this company?
It's beautiful. I mean, you come in and it's just such a beautiful, eclectic mix of what Ghana is. You've got testimonials and homage to our ancestors. You have beauty. You have Marcus Garvey on the walls. And it's just, I don't know, it's something about it where it just feels home. It's and this is what Accra is when I come here. It's a Kwaba. It's a welcome. Okay. It's a welcome.
You know, the housewives of Atlanta, right? The last thing I personally would have attributed to you is the connection that because you do your thing. You know what I mean? But to know that I've followed your posting, the diaspora connection means so much to you. What is so important about that?
You know, it's my heritage, and I don't take, growing up in Canada, having parents that, my dad is a guy, he was born and raised in Accra, he lived here for most of his adult life, served in the military, and then came to Canada to go to med school. He met my mom, who was British, but I know my history. And it was something that, you know, as a Canadian, I almost took for granted until I grew up and traveled to the United States, where so many people don't know their history, and it's so tied to me that there is not a day that goes by that I'm not grateful to be a Ghanaian, to have these traditions, to understand the food, the culture, to know where I came from. It is just not something that we should take lightly, because the culture here, it's so rich, and it makes us, you know, the gold that we are of this world.
So you were born in Canada. Is this your first time in Ghana?
No. We grew up going back and forth.
Okay.
So from a little kid, from a small child, we would come back and forth. My grandparents were here. I'm grateful that I got to meet my grandparents. I have aunties, uncles, cousins here that I've grown up with. This is family. This is home.
And this trip has been, from all your postings, it's been like, how different is this trip from the past one?
You know, because we've just gone through this world pandemic, we've had COVID, you know, we've lost so many lives across the world. It just, the gratitude I have for being able to come and see my dad, come and see my aunties, to see faces that, you know, you can't take for granted life and where you come from. My appreciation for everything is just so much more. And I just want to be able to share with so many people across, you know, all these diasporans, all the Africans, all the black people who have now taken such interest in our culture. I want them to understand what a place Ghana is.
Okay. So I take it that you're going to bring your sisters with you next time.
Yes.
Okay. What are you going to tell them when you go there?
Yes. We're going to come. We're going to dance. We're going to eat. You're going to understand the food. You're going to be able to travel all through this beautiful country. And it's just, it's an incredible place to visit. And you are remiss if you don't get a chance to come here.
Very good. And you opened it, so I'll let you close it. When you see folks in the black struggle, there seems to be a separation between Hollywood show business and the actual people in the trenches. It seems to me in Tanya, you have a mixture of both.
We have everything in Tanya. And that's what I can't let her hands go. I'm going to hold her forever.
Talk about possessiveness. Can I also touch her hand?
I'll let you. you touch her hand. I'll let you touch her hand. That's all. I'll let you
That's
touch
all.
Her hand. But again, I just really, again, want to close by saying thank you to you. Because it's so important. I know the personal sacrifices that you have made. I know what you have gone through to make DNT what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to just take my hat off to you and say thank you to all the DNT people.